Legends of industries long gone litter the Cornish coast. A reminder that people have been coming here for centuries. First for the mineral wealth, now for the stunning scenery. This is West Penwith. It takes its name from the old Cornish words for promontory or headland at the end. And it really is right at the end of the county.
It's hardly surprising that so many visitors are drawn to this part of the world with iconic views like this one here of St. Michael's Mount. And it's difficult not to be inspired by the rugged beauty of this coastline, which is the purpose of my little boat trip today.
Thanks to the mineral-rich rocks around here, this scenery has a stunning palette of colours, which might explain why Cornwall has such a well-established artistic tradition. I've come to find out about one artist's very different approach to keeping that tradition alive, and to have a bit of a painting masterclass. But to get there, I'm hitching a lift with Reggie Allen.
Well, Reg, this is the life, isn't it?
Yeah, not bad. Better this morning, all the sun was shining.
Yeah. Still lovely, though.
Well, I've got a bit of Cornish sunshine at the moment, the old nice. Raindrops.
Have you always had a connection with the sea?
Yeah, pretty much. Since I've been about 5 or 6 years old, yeah, my father, we had ferry boats at St. Michael's Mount, so I've always, yeah, been on the boats with him and took over when he retired, really.
And that's your line of work now, then, the ferry boats?
Yeah, mainly. In the summertime, it's ferry boats, and in the winter, I do waste disposal work, like, you know,
Nice. Okay.
Building sites and stuff like that, clear all the rubbish up.
Yeah. Do you do any fishing yourself, though?
Yeah, I take out the old fishing trip now and again.
What about art trips?
No, this is the first.
This is the first one, right. Yeah. Okay, well, I've got to get the wetsuit on, so I'll get soon enough.
I'm rendezvousing offshore with Sarah Adams. She's one of the long line of artists to have made a home in this county. And her traditional approach combined with a modern perspective of the Cornish coast has proved popular. With successful exhibitions in the capital, her paintings now command a high price.
Hiya Sarah, how are you?
I'm fine.
Now this is a first for me. I've never seen a dog in a kayak. Hello, Blue. Right, okay, so we're gonna head off. Are we just stop around the coast a little bit?
Yeah.
So when did you start mixing art and kayaking?
It's easier to go on foot, but I like places where the sea's just been. Some of the places, you just can't get to any other way.
Yeah.
And that's the attraction of these remote places, which is so inaccessible to most people. And of course, the dogs. These hidden coves are a striking subject matter. But even on a grey day like this, Sarah's searching out the colours and textures in the rocks all around us.
Here you've got the oxides leaching out of the rocks and some of the sheared planes of the slate.
Yeah.
And also you see that you've got some copper washing out. You see that lovely green?
Thoughts? What do you reckon? It's a good spot?
It's nice to see something out. Rather than looking in. So, good spot. You happy with that?
Let's go for it.
Come on then.
Let's do it.
Everything's been carefully packed in waterproof bags to survive the journey. I just hope we haven't forgotten anything.
There's
a paint's already laid out and ready to go.
Yeah, well, it just saves time, really.
It's all oil, then.
It's all oil, yeah. And then this is what you're going to be painting on. Some oak face ply. And it's been primed, and it's had a colour wash on it, which gives a bit of colour to work against, rather than just a white background. I'm just going to take a little bit of this warm stuff. You see that little bit there? So I'm just going to get a sense of that, just roughly, and that coming down there, and that line, and you're just sketching it in.
Sarah makes it look easy, but I'm a little bit daunted. This is the first time I've ever used oils.
Got blue in already. Got no. Blue. Wow.
Only a little bit.
This looks great though.
If I were you, just get a bit more paint on there.
Right. Okay?
And also don't forget you've got that bit of cloth. Coming out here and going to all this trouble, get kayaks and climbing into caves and all that,
yeah.
It's to get as much information as possible. It won't be photographic accuracy, but it will be a representation of the subject.
Well, I'm not sure how representative mine will be, but I'll keep going. doesn't seem too impressed. Falling asleep.
So what do you do with the majority of the workmen that you introduce?
Well, all sorts of things like this go back to the studio, and then some of the subjects end up on canvases up to 7 or 8 foot.
Wow.
I'll work and let it dry and then work again and keep doing that, and you know, it's about 6 months' work usually. Mm-hmm.
How do you know when to stop?
Well, with a small thing like this, it's often when the tide comes in and it's lapping at your feet.
Yes.
So, also, working on site, the light changes. So in half an hour, you'll find that all the shadows are different, the lights change completely. I suppose 2 hours is tops, otherwise things change radically. So there's a natural limit to working on site.
It's time to reveal our masterpieces.
I think that's worked out well.
My effort. It's a little bit random in parts, but yours, however, is phenomenal.
Well, it's starting to come, but I'll come back here and do some more sketchbook work, and you never know, it might lead to a bigger painting.
This has certainly been one creative journey that I won't forget in a hurry.
Let's go.
It's time to paddle back out to sea and leave our secluded subject matter behind.
Driven up the price of basics such as bread and meat, but is there another factor that's going on behind the scenes, far away from our farmyards and fields, where John has been to investigate?
The songs of seabirds and crashing waves have echoed around the Cornish coast for thousands of years. But back in the 1930s, something extra was added to the mix. The sound of drama. That's when Minack Point became home to its very own open-air theatre.
Well, this place is absolutely gobsmacking. It looks like it should be more at home in ancient Greece than the West Country, but the Minack Theatre is definitely not a ruin.
The theatre here was the vision of one woman, Rowena Cade, and she literally built this place stone by stone with the help of just a couple of local craftsmen. Theatre manager Phil Jackson first worked at the Minack when he was a teenager.
So Phil, you actually knew Rowena. What was she like?
A lot of people knew her and they saw her as a sort of Victorian headmistress type, you know. She grew up in a genteel Victorian background and you don't see her as someone who's going to mix concrete for 40 years of her life.
No, so she was an actress then?
No, she wasn't an actress, but she was a talented artist, seamstress, and she got involved locally making costumes for a local amateur theatre and designing sets, and they got a bit adventurous and decided to do open-air theatre. And this was her Cliff Garden. She was already terracing it as in Cliff Garden, but then she looked at this and thought, well, it's a natural amphitheatre shape, you know, I can do something with this. And so with her gardener, they sort of scraped all the undergrowth out, built a wall along the back, and they had a theatre. I mean, she built the last feature when she was 81. You know, she was sort of physically active, mixing concrete in the winter, so they...
Of course, putting on productions in an environment like this comes with its challenges. I'm thinking about the weather.
It's not always like this. I mean, we've got the Atlantic right here, and so we do get some interesting seas and gales to challenge us. But we play on, you know, it's open-air theatre. Some people call it extreme sport.
Yeah.
You come here prepared for open-air theatre, and hopefully most people are prepared to take what comes at them.
Well, I've seen it from this perspective, but I'm going to have a little wander down there and see what it's like down on the old stage.
Enjoy yourself.
See you later. Don't heckle me.
I won't.
Oh, it's your fault!
It's a big night for the Dream Team Theatre Company. It'll be their first performance at the Minack, where they've sold out, filling over 700 seats. Tonight's show is Around the World in 80 Days. And while I'm here, I might as well try my hand at Phileas Fogg.
That's
Martin.
That's
Martin.
Over here.
There you are. Right, I've located our transport.
Oh, good. Not an elephant, I hope.
We have been fortunate enough to land a short distance away from Townrowth, a tin mine built this very year on the north coast of Cornwall.
What's the coast? How will we make it to the train station?
I think I need to work on the accent. Something maybe a little more upper crust and less Terry Wogan. From an engine that was designed to help the tin miner, we build an airship. Yeah, thanks very much. Cheers. Well, as far as outdoor theatres go, they don't come much better than this. opening look at that spectacular scenery.
And later I'll be joined by my fiercest critic. I wonder what Julia will make of my Phileas Fogg. But first, with over 1,000 sheep of all breeds, Adam's got his work cut out on the farm. The end of lambing's in sight, but before a well-earned rest, there's important parenting to do. At this
But I haven't got time to stand and stare. I'm on my way to meet Matt, who's trying out for the part of Phileas Fogg. This is Minnock Point, the end of my ward, and have you ever seen a theatre anything like that before? What a spectacular situation. And what every performer needs is an appreciative audience.
Passepartout!
There you are.
Ooh!
I've located our transportation.
Rubbish!
Shut up, man, I'm trying to concentrate. Here we go. Passepartout.
What's that voice?
Oh, there you are. That's actually my opening line in the scene.
Is it?
Yeah, thanks for that. It's really
helping. So, here I am exploring the great outdoors, and you find a theatre in the showbiz box. You're in Top Hat and Tails.
Of course, yeah. I was in a wetsuit earlier.
Have you got any fake tan on today?
No.
No, okay. So, how's rehearsal going?
Very good, actually. There's actually a really nice little part here for you.
I don't want a little part, I want a big part.
Okay, let's have a quick look through and we'll talk you through it.